guess my favorite of my two favorite was Plato's Stepchildren, and had that wonderful scene with the captain in which we were forced to entertain the people on that planet by making love in an arena. And it turned out to be the first interracial kiss on television, of which I was totally unaware.
Well, you always hope to do stories that, you know, are good and meaningful. For instance, a show called Plato's Stepchildren. I know it's very sad to think that the thought of a white man kissing a black woman is a fantastic catastrophe.
Nothing like that had really happened on television before.
This was 1968, and it had never, I mean, nobody had even touched each other on the screen who was a black person or a white person. There was no romantic involvement even by holding hands. So kissing was a big deal in 1968.
Yeah, I recall, I think it was in children's television, you didn't have a black man pick up a white child. It was okay for a nanny, a black woman.
It's hard to imagine it now, but it was almost 30 years ago.
What a charming negress. Oh, forgive me, my dear. I know that in my time some use that term as a description of property.
But why should I object to that term, sir? You see, in our century, we've learned not to fear words.
Many young people watching television today assume that it's always been that way. But when Gene Roddenberry put Star Trek on television, it was a rare thing. It was groundbreaking. This was the first interracial cast in a successful television series ever. It changed the face of television. Now it's very commonplace, but then it simply was not.
Welcome to our republic. Who among you is the physician?
I am. What's the problem?
I played a Greek, sort of a Greek-style queen, and she controlled everybody through the use of her mind. In this particular episode, it was the first interracial kiss on network television. And the only reason that the network allowed that kiss was because I forced them to kiss.
Let's get on with it.
The publicity was great on it. I mean, the network came with still photographers. They publicized it in advance. I think they wanted to prepare the public for this big event. I mean, it seems incredible now to think of it that way, but that's the way it was.
White man kissing a black woman. And Kirk, the star of the show, I wanted him to do this, and I didn't want Spock to do it because this was having an alien kiss Uhura being forced instead of a white man.
Oh, how faceless and fickle.
Now, I had a tremendous problem with program practices, which from the network, because they were very concerned.
They stopped shooting and brought down Gene Roddenberry and some of the suits from the studio.
You know, an astounding, I mean, it boggles the mind.
Too much love is dangerous.
And I've always had a pretty good relationship with program practices. They do their job, they have to do their job, but this was anathema to them. You know, how is it going to work in the South? How is it going to be this? And
I'm so frightened, Captain. I'm so very frightened.
I didn't give it a second thought. And neither did they until it was pointed out. And suddenly they came out and Gene said one of his famous lines, "Let's shoot it both ways."
Make up your minds.
Well, Bill Shatner, bless his heart, was determined the kiss was going to be in. And so he bollocksed up every take that came on and used up all the time because it was the last day of shooting and it was the last scene being shot. And if we didn't get it that day, that scene would not have been in there, and it had to be in there.
And finally they had about 5 minutes left and they're tearing their hair out. We've got to go for the one without the kiss. So I'd get you here, and he's making me giggle, you know. And when they're finally shooting it, Bill crossed his eyes in the camera. So there was no way they could use that. And that's how the first interracial kiss happened to take place on television.